welcome each and every one of you to Miami Dade College for coming out to our event today. So right now, I would like to introduce our keynote speaker. Ms. Green is an award-winning journalist at WLRN, South Florida's NPR station. She covers issues around race, equity, and social justice. She previously worked at the Miami Herald. For her, journalism is not only about reaching out to communities that are not typically heard, but uplifting their narratives. She is a first-generation Haitian-American who jokes. She didn't even know that she really was growing up into the U.S. until she started school, because her parents were just so Haitian. She studied English with a specialization in professional writing at Barry University. So can everyone please stand to give Ms. Nadege Green a warm welcome to Miami Dade College.
Like no one knows it's Haitian Black Day but Haitians. I didn't go to a school with a lot of Haitians in it. And she was like, well, you have to wear this because it's Haitian Flag Day and this matters that you show up like this at school today. And I looked at my dad and I was like, Dad, please don't make her let me do this. And he was like, you have to do what your mom says. So I remember in the third grade, I showed up to school, the only kid dressed up in a traditional Haitian outfit, head tied up with a bandana, she put on gold boots and lipstick. And was like, go forward. And that whole day, everyone stopped me like, why are you dressed like that? And I'm like, it's Haitian Flag Day. What's Haitian Flag Day? And I had to explain that to them. And I didn't fully understand like what that moment meant until I got much older, but it forced me to A, identify not just as Haitian at home, but also what it meant to be Haitian outside of the home, and to be able to speak our story to other people who may not know our stories. And so throughout my childhood, I think the Haitian Revolution was very much a part of my childhood. My parents were social justice people. They were always at an immigrant rights protest. They were always protesting for fair rights for Haitians in Miami. So, like, if I messed up at school, if I was just having a crisis of confidence, my dad always talked about the Haitian Revolution. He was like, do you know who you are? And I'm like, I know who I am. And he would say, no, you don't understand. And I think his messaging was always, your ancestors are powerful people. Your ancestors overthrew one of the most powerful armies to get rid of slavery and the horror and the terrorism that was in Haiti. So if they can do that, you can do math. You know, if they can do that, you'll be okay. That was always the messaging we got at home. Like, just don't forget who you are. And what that did was not only instill a sense of pride in me or confidence, but it also made me want to know history. Like, when they talked about the Haitian Revolution, when they talked about Toussaint Louverture or Jean-Jacques Dessalines, which was always a topic in some way, shape, or form in our household, I was curious about that, and I was always a nerd. So I read a lot of books about the Haitian Revolution at a time when you couldn't find those books in schools, but I spent a lot of time in the libraries. And one of the things I love about the story of the Haitian Revolution is that it wasn't just about freeing Haiti. It was a Black consciousness and idea that we are not free until all of us are free. And so Haiti played a very important and active role in helping liberate not just itself, but Latin American countries from colonial rule. Today the theme is bridging the culture. And I think the Haitian Revolution is the perfect thing to talk about when we talk about bridging the culture across the Black diaspora. We hear a lot about the divides in our community, like, oh, well, I don't really mess with African-Americans, or African-Americans don't like Haitians, I don't like Cubans, or you know what the divide is across the diaspora. But I reject that because I think the Haitian Revolution is, okay, it's working now. But I think the Haitian Revolution sort of charted the path that we can be interconnected beyond our individual selves. So in 1812, for example, after the Haitian Revolution, there was a rebellion in Cuba. Jose Antonio Aponte led a rebellion in Cuba. And he carried with him photos of Toussaint Louverture, Jean-Jacques Dessalines, with the same idea of getting rid of slavery in Cuba. It didn't work because he was killed. Because the idea of what it means to be a revolutionary was not received, right? That is scary to systems. And when I think about the Haitian Revolution, you can't think about it and not think of South America. Venezuela, for example, was liberated by Simon Bolivar. Simon Bolivar found refuge in Haiti. And when he found refuge in Haiti, one of the things that the Haitian president told him was, when you free Venezuela, you free all the slaves in Venezuela. So this idea that we are interconnected and that when like all of our freedom is tied together is very much a part of the Haitian Revolution story. One that we don't talk about enough. That is not just the story of Haiti, but it's the story of Latin America too. It's the story of the US. As a student of history, you will read that there were minor rebellions here in the US. Many pointed to Haiti, right? That the idea that Haitian Revolution gave enslaved people hope is real, whether we're talking about the US, Latin America, or even in France. Like what it means to have been born out of this revolution. So for me, when I think of the messaging around this month. And this month is fun. You know, Pompa Fest is coming up. Everyone's going to turn up. There's going to be Lago Dai, Pompa, and everything else that comes with that. And there's also this month of what it means to be Haitian and what it means to exist as a Haitian person within the Miami context, period. I think the Haitian Revolution is central to that. And so as you explore this month and further, I would implore you all to really get to know your history, because when you know your history, it's really hard for people to tell you something negative, right? Like, it is very real that as a student, maybe less so now, but when I was in school, there was a lot of negativity around what it meant to be Haitian. Many of my peers wouldn't even show up in school with a bandana on their head or a shirt like many of you are wearing today. Not because of shame, but because of bullying. This idea that being Haitian was other, the idea that being Haitian wasn't cool or something to be. I think we've overcome a lot of that, and I think part of that is just knowing your history and knowing your story. So thank you all so much for having me, and I hope you enjoy the rest of your day.
Sans passer, n'a manger. All right, perfect. You guys are awake. Give her a round of applause, everybody. That was a very, very powerful speech. I can empathize with that because I was born as a Haitian American here in the U.S. And right after that, I just learned English in ESOL classes for 3 years, so I can really, really connect with that story. So I'm gonna go ahead and invite Crystal Dunn to the podium. Give her a round of applause, everyone.
Thank you.